control. But now he's telling it's going to happen 2045. Many scientists predict it's going to happen much earlier than that, 2035. So people are pretty scary, but anyway, let's see what is it telling. Okay.
I have just turned 50, but my appearance is of somebody of 85. I suffer from serious kidney problems because I do not drink enough water. I am afraid I do not have much time left to live. I am one of the oldest people in the society.
A 50-year-old man looking like 85-year-old man. Okay, next slide.
I remember when I was a child of 5, everything was very different then. There were lots of trees in the parks, houses with beautiful gardens, and I could enjoy having a shower for half an hour. Nowadays, we use towels with mineral oil to clean our skin.
There's no water, the bathroom dishes, and oil to wipe out our dirt from the body because of the no water, right?
Before, women had beautiful hair. Now, we have to shave our heads to keep them clean without the use of water. Then, my father washed his car with water coming out of a hose pipe. Now, my son does not believe that water could be wasted that way.
Can you imagine? No chance, no water. We wasted water, our generation. So many homes, factories, Coca-Cola, Sprite, all these started and we treated water. Future without water. It's our evil generation. Never forgive us. Actually, you should have stones in your hands. Hit me. Not real stones, like paper, you make paper. So we are serious dangerous. We are not, we didn't think about the future. Children at all. Selfish. Only me. Only my family, my children. Profit me. Self. Ego. But if we talk of common good, samvodaya, how mindset will be entirely different. We put our empathy. So we didn't do that. We lost it. Next.
I remember there were save water warnings on outside posters, radio, and TV. But nobody paid attention. We thought that water was to last forever. Now, all the rivers, lakes, dams, and underground water beds are either dry or contaminated.
There is no underwater now. Yes, it rained, we have a little bit of water here and there. Chennai, complete drought. Do you know what happened last May? No water. In Vellore, I come from Vellore. I don't call it a Vellore, I call it a Hellore. It looks like hell, ghost town, no water. India is going to face an enormous amount of water crisis. Yes. Already we are facing. Manmohan Singh warned 10 years ago. Manmohan Singh, our former Prime Minister, warned it's going to be serious problem in India, water.
Industry came virtually to a standstill and unemployment reached dramatic proportions. Desalination plants are the main source of employment and workers receive part of their salary in drinkable water.
The only industry is desalination plants. You take, you make drinking water from the seawater. That is a big industry, but it costs a lot of fuel, more pollution side. So water is produced, that's all. Only industry, all the industries depend on water.
the recommended quality of water to drink for an adult was 8 glasses a day. Nowadays, I'm only allowed half a glass. We now have to wear disposable clothing and this increases the amount of litter. We are using now septic tanks because the sewage system does not work for lack of water.
Systems are collapsing. desert ecosystem, because that is where our future is. That our future is ecosystem, we live in an ecosystem. So I'm going to explain something through illustration so that you can grasp. Because I told you everything is mystery. Everything is mysterious. Unless you dig deep, you can't understand. So our ancestors did not teach us because they did not contemplate. They didn't contemplate. So, but today we need to contemplate. This generation has to dig out the scientific truth and bring to the focus of the younger generation. All right? Come to you.
Three components every ecosystem has.
here, plants won't take off, even in your house, in your backyard, front yard. Today, when you go home or tomorrow, you check out what kind of primary producers you have in your home, in your ecosystem, in your village. And then what kind of consumers you have. How many rabbits, how many foxes, how many snakes, how many scorpions, how many insects you have in your own backyard, front yard, birds, reptiles, mammals. At last you can check this out because they are invisible. They are in your soil. They are living creatures. That's why we call it soil is living. It's a living soil. It's a habitat. It's not a dead. Soil is living. Thousands of creatures are living in the soil. And we don't have a right to pollute and kill them by pumping chemicals in the soil. But this is not. After that, I will explain how it is organized.
Yeah.
So if you do that, we are not going to change business as usual. There is no change at all. We are going to maintain the same thing. We are going to ruin our planet. Still faster. That's what we do. Okay. Next.
When my son asked me to talk about my youth, I tell him about the green fields, the beauty of the flowers, the rain, how pleasant it was to swim and fish in the rivers and dams, to drink all the water we could, and how healthy people was. He asks, Daddy, why there is no water? Then I feel a lump in my throat. I cannot help feeling guilty because I belong to the generation who contributed to the destruction of the environment or simply did not take into account all the warning signs.
So, you should not be under guilty verdict of this. If you want to change the course of history, you should not be damned by this bad moment. So, you don't want to inherit this guilty verdict. That is our duty for you. So that should never inflict on you. So you need to wipe out. So you need to repair. And you should escape from that duty for you. That's why you are here today. That's why here. You need to convert us. You need to forgive this generation. And then you have to show the way. In order to show the investigate. You need to invent something, otherwise you can't show the way. You are going to the victims of our own way. Business as usual. You are going to be the victims, that's all. You should show the new way.
Now, our children pay a very high price.
That is you who are paying the high price. So you are the victim. We have contaminated the whole new generation of youngsters. And we don't know how to guide them. That is that. We don't know how to lead them. All of them are out of ideas. There is no creativity. Only invention of new computers, new cell phones, and new factories. And new depletion of resources and increasing the GDP. GDP. You know what is a GDP? You don't know GDP? Indian GDP, we talk all the gross, domestic, product. That is gross, domestic, product. Okay, next. See, this is the comment comes from a famous scientist, Abdul Kalam. So this is a prediction. This is a prediction. Okay, read it.
I sincerely believe that within a short time, life on Earth will not be possible. As the destruction of nature reached now an irreversible stage.
So that is what Abdul Kalam prophetically predicted. That is, there is a truth as a scientist, but I hope that is not true. I want to believe that is not true. I want to believe. But he is a scientist. Maybe he is right. I wish this will not come true. We all pray and work hard. I sincerely believe that within a short time, life on Earth will not be possible as the destruction of nature reached now an irreversible state. That means whatever we do, we are not going to repair it. Because now the greenhouse has become runaway greenhouse effect. You know what I mean? Runaway greenhouse. Can you come here? One minute. Why don't you come and sit down here? You are near the irreversible stage, you have reached. So I wish we are in the state of random greenhouse effect. Forget about greenhouse effect. That's an old story. Runaway means whatever you do, you are not going to repent. You are not going to solve the problem. Runaway. We lost the moment. You should have really worked hard some 30 years ago or 20 years ago. But we were not at all doing anything. But now we lost it. Next. How I would like to go back and make mankind understand that we still have time to save our planet Earth. Forget about saving planet Earth. Planet Earth will save itself. But you are not going to save planet Earth. Planet Earth has seen 4.5 million years of history. Planet Earth knows very well how to survive. It's about us. How are we going to save ourselves? That is the point. How humans? This is about our human extinction. The extinction means all the humans will die. We are talking about not the extinction of dinosaurs, not the extinction of fishes, whales, snakes. It's an extinction of human species. 7.5 million people. So that is what. Next one. So this show was made by a very talented person named Abdul Kalam. I thank him for making us aware. Now he is dead, but he passed the message to us. It is up to us. He wants us to live. He wants us to flourish. Be happy. So he warned us some 20, 25 years ago, but nobody has, even in the school level, nobody has shown you. Anybody saw this PowerPoint before? Anybody? You saw. Anybody else? Two. Anybody else? Yeah, only two. See? That is the irresponsibility of our generation. Teachers, principals, those who are head of the institutions, nobody taught me. How many children? This PowerPoint came 15 years ago. 15 years. Not 15, let's say 10 years. No, 2009, yeah. 2009. So that makes it 10 years. See? And your parents, they didn't show anything to you. Your grandparents, nothing. So how can you forgive all of them? That is so sad. This came so many years. See, just now I'm running it from the internet. I don't have the PowerPoint. I just running in my computer internet. I just typed Abdul Kalam's. Life on Earth is not possible. I entered that problem. So when you go home, you can download.